Hello and welcome to the Probability and Computing Problem Solving series. So today we'll be solving
So when the fair coin is flipped 10 times, we have to have more heads than tails, right? Which means that what are the possibilities? Let's see the favorable cases, right? This is the number of heads and this is the number of tails. Okay, so yeah, it has to be either 6-4 or 7-3 or 8-2 or 9-1 or 10-0, right? So okay, and let's call these events e1 is the event where the number of heads is 6 and number of tails is 4. Let's call this event E2. E2 is the event where number of heads is 7 and number of tails is 3. Okay, and so on. So E3, E4, E5. Okay, this E5. Sorry for that. Okay, so these are the 5 events, right? So either E1 or E2 or E3 or E4 E5, if it happens, then we are fine, right? I mean, what is the probability of that happening is what we need to find out, right? Because there should be more heads than tails, right? Now yeah, so it boils down to the case that what is the probability of E1 or E2 or E3 or E4 or E5 happening, right? This is nothing but the probability of union of EIs, right? Basically, so a union is our I equal to 1 to 5, right? Now, are these events disjoint? Yes, so they are disjoint, right? So because these events are disjoint, and why these events are disjoint basically? So if you see these events, there is nothing in common, right? So they are all disjoint events. That's why they are disjoint. Okay, there is nothing in common. Okay, now since they are disjoint, we can use this formula, right? So where P of union of EIs is basically equal to summation of P of EIs, right? So it boils down to the case where we need to just add up these probabilities: probability of E1 happening plus probability of E2 happening plus probability of E3 happening plus probability of E4 happening plus probability of E5 happening. Alright, now let's find out the individual probabilities. So probability of E1, what is that? So E1 is the case where there are 6 heads and 4 tails. For that to happen, we know we can select heads in 10 choose 6 ways, right? 10 choose 6 ways, we can select the positions for the heads to appear, right? And remaining all places, automatically tails will come, right? So 10 choose 6 such cases are possible, and each of them happens with probability 1 by 2 raised to 6 into 1 by 2 raised to 4, that is 1 by 2 whole raised to 10, right? Because it's a fair coin, and probability of head appearing in one of the coin toss is 1 by 2 or equal to the probability that tail appears in that coin toss, right? So this is the required probability, right? Now again, so what is P of E2? E2 means there are 7 heads and 3 tails, right? So 7 heads means 10 choose 7 ways we can select the positions for where heads to appear, and automatically rest of the positions tails will come. So 10 choose 7 ways heads positions we can select. So basically number of such outcomes possible where 7 heads and 3 tails are there are 10 choose 7, and each of them happens with probability 1 by 2 raised to 10, 1 by 2 raised to 7, 10 comes because of 1 by 2 raised to 7 into 1 by 2 raised to 3, right? So that's why. And similarly, we can see that probability in a similar manner, probability of E3 is 1 by 2 raised to 10 into 10 choose 8, right? And probability of E4 is 1 by 2 raised to 10 into 10 choose 9, right? And finally, so probability of E5 means 10 heads, right? So 10 choose 10 into 1 by 2 raised to 10. Okay, so you just add up this probability. So finally what we need is probability of E1 plus probability of E2 plus probability of E3 plus probability of E4 plus probability of E5. Finally, this is what we want, right? So we have now P of E5, P of E4, P of E3, P of E2 we have, and finally P of E1 also we have. So we just add up this, okay? And finally, okay, I'll say the answer that we get. You can do the computation, that's easy. Okay, now the answer what we will get is 386 by 2 raised to 10. Okay, and that is the required probability. Okay, so if you have any doubt or any queries to us, please comment in the comment section below. Hope to see you in the next video. Thank you.